Hi guys, so in this video I just wanted to give my views on the Celestron zoom eyepiece. It's a 1.25 inch eyepiece, and with it you can basically have the same effect of using an eyepiece from 8mm all the way to 24mm. And as you can see it on this on the eyepiece here itself, the markings for 8 to 12 18 and 24, and this is one eyepiece which I use in almost every time that I take my telescope out, and I found it to be extremely useful. And compared to say having multiple eyepiece and then having to swap them out each time. So one really great feature about this eyepiece is that it has grooves on the viewing end. So what this allows us to do is to attach it to a camera adapter that you might have, and you know, that's pretty useful if you want to do eyepiece projection, or also called as a focal astrophotography. And this is what I regularly do when I'm trying to image the planets, because I can connect the eyepiece to the Barlow lens and then get a magnified view of planets pretty easily. So here I'll just show you how I can connect it to my camera. So I have a Nikon mirrorless camera, and I have an adapter for it which I will attach to the camera. So once we attach the adapter to the camera, so you can see it has grooves on the inside of the adapter, and there are grooves on the outer edge of the zoom eyepiece, so we can just screw it in. And the neat thing about this is that basically you can adjust the magnification of the image that is going into your camera, and that would not be possible say if you're doing you know, without an eyepiece in between. So this really helps when you are, especially for planetary imaging where you want to adjust the magnification and see what kind of details you're able to get on the camera. It really helps, and there's no hassle of changing the lens and things like that. So for eyepiece projection photography, this is really useful. So on the other end of the eyepiece also we have grooves on the inside, and this allows us to attach filters, like for example this moon filter that I have, that cuts down the amount of light when we are viewing the full moon, and basically it will improve the contrast. So this filter or any other filter, we could attach it to the other side of the eyepiece. So this is also a nice feature. So one thing to note is that when you change the eyepiece length, focal length, what will happen is that the focus will change. So you would need to adjust the draw tube on your telescope. You would need to adjust the focus so that it comes back into focus. So once you switch from say 8 to 12 or something like that, you will need to adjust the focus on the telescope to you know, basically get the image back in focus. But it's not too complicated. It's still easier than swapping out eyepieces. So for example, if you're changing from 8 to 12, you will have to move the eyepiece farther away from the secondary mirror. So yeah, you would need to adjust the scope in there. Also in this one you can see the change in the field of view. So this gives you an idea of what it looks like even when you are viewing the scope. So there is a change in the field of view that you will experience when you're going from the shortest to the highest. So here you can see the view of Mars at 24mm through this eyepiece. And I'm going to adjust the zoom level so that I take it from 24mm to say a lower number like 18. And you can see that it is going out of focus. So this is expected. So when this goes out of focus, we will have to use the focuser on the telescope to get it back in focus and then continue. So at each time that you're going to change the eyepiece focal length, the view will go out of focus and you will need to adjust the focuser so that it gets back in focus, which is relatively easier compared to say when you're swapping out eyepieces. So I really find this eyepiece quite useful, and you know, I use it regularly. And if you are on a limited budget, then I would suggest that you buy a zoom eyepiece like this Celestron one. And this one is below $100 and pretty affordable. So that is better than, see, getting a big eyepiece kit initially. So this is a really good buy, and I found it really, really useful. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please do leave a like, share it, and also subscribe to my channel. And thanks a lot for watching.